वी आर ऑलमोस्ट डन विथ आवर टर्बुलेंट फ्लोज लेक्चर्स. ओनली वन चैप्टर इज लेफ्ट विच आई मे टेक अप इन द नेक्स्ट क्लास. इन दिस क्लास वी विल ट्राई टू सीक द ब्लेशियस. Solution through MATLAB software and using function ODE 45. This ODE 45, MATLAB has an inbuilt function which solves ordinary differential equation. Okay, and inbuilt it actually uses the algorithm or the numerical technique called Runge-Kutta method. Or shooting method. So let us first formulate our governing equation. What was our governing equation? Let me rewrite that. So we had already, all of you have done f triple dash plus half of f times f double dash is equal to zero, and dashes are essentially in with respect to eta variables. So I may rewrite this differential equation. This is an ordinary differential equation, which is the order of ordinary differential equation is third order. So this is nothing but d cube f by d eta cube plus half of f times d 2f by d eta square is equal to zero, and we have certain sets of boundary conditions, which is f of 0 where eta is equal to 0, it is 0, f dash 0 is equal to 0, and we have last boundary condition as at the extreme end is f dash at eta tends to infinity or above boundary layer should be equal to 1. These three boundary conditions we need to solve this. So this is a complete set of mathematical formulation with boundary conditions. But the problem with this, the solution of this ordinary differential equation is, we can go by Runge-Kutta or shooting method only when we are given initial conditions for let me write this way. Okay. Let me write this way. If we have initial conditions for all the derivatives are given. So first, I mean, without derivative, the function's value, we know the first derivative initial condition is also given, but the second derivative initial condition is not known. We can actually guess this value, and now in more appropriate way, now this equation is closed if we at all we have to use these boundary conditions. Okay, and I mean, this is not the only criteria we should satisfy. We should also satisfy the last an additional condition which dictates from this guy over here, because these two has already been satisfied, and I have made these things, I mean these boundary conditions, in this way because the Runge-Kutta or the shooting method works this way. Okay, it needs the initial conditions value for all the derivatives. Then only it can solve, go for solve solution. But we have here, this is not initial condition. We have essentially this is the boundary value. So essentially this is a boundary value problem, but we are going to convert it into initial value problem. Okay, it was a boundary value problem. But we are going to convert it into initial value problem by this way, and also satisfying f dash at some infinity. I may take some higher value, but suppose I am taking 10, f dash 10 must be equal to 1. So we have these initial conditions, some guess value, and then guess values is should be chosen in such a way that it should satisfy f dash 0 is equal to 1. This is how it is. This Bloch's solution is being formulated numerically. I mean, we are going to go into the numerical way. Okay, let us let me share my MATLAB interface from another laptop. I cannot, so it's not installed in my Surface laptop. So I have to, let me join this from another laptop. Share this screen from you guys are able to see my you are able to see my MATLAB interface, right? Are you?
Yes, sir.
Okay. So let us so just to give you a preface, what I believe that you guys might not have any expertise in MATLAB. Okay. So what I will do, I will just give you overview what exactly MATLAB is all about. So MATLAB, the MATLAB is a mathematical tool through which we can take help to solve our mathematical equations, algebraic. Either it can be algebraic, it can be differential equations, either it could be ordinary or it could be partial differential equations. Any such kind, you want to take Fourier transform, you want to take out frequencies. So it can have, it's a very powerful tool. You can do any sort of mathematical manipulation, or you can code, or you can do any manipulation in this MATLAB tool. And this MATLAB works on matrix. So the full form of MATLAB is MAT. So this MAT stands for matrix, and lab stands for laboratory. Okay, and whatever the operation this MATLAB does is based on matrix operation only. Okay, how many of you are actually comfortable with MATLAB. If none of you, I can start with basics and then I will switch back to our solving this equation. But let me take the feedback from you guys. How many of you are
basics, sir?
Basics means you can plot, you can do sort of certain things. At least, can you make a plot in MATLAB, sine of x, sine of y? Can you do that?
No, sir.
Okay, so let me go through that first, and so that you can see what is cooking in MATLAB actually. So we start with very basics of MATLAB. So I told you it is just a matrix operation. It either so let me define my first variable. A is equal to 2. When I hit enter. Okay, so before that, so there are certain toolbars you can see over here. These are the menu toolbars. You have new script, new open, all sorts of things are there. And you have plotting options, you have certain apps, additional apps are there. So no need to go into there. At this left hand side toolbar is your current folder where your MATLAB directory is pointing out right now. So this is your, this is the folder which currently MATLAB is pointing to. So whatever file in it here, it will reflect over here. So I have already did a Blasius MATLAB code in it and it is kept over here. So that is why it is shown over here. So this is your directory folder. This particular guy, command window. So this is your command window where you can give any command. Okay, clear all, A is equal to 2. When I hit A is equal to 2, I'm giving command to this MATLAB. So when I hit enter, so it actually takes the value A is equal to 0 and it is saved in your workspace. Okay, and when I double click this workspace A, when I double click it, you will see that I have 1x1. So it takes in the form of matrices. Okay, so this is a scalar, but this is 1x1 matrix it generated with the element value 2 in it. That's all. Okay, so let us make a vector in A. So when I write B is equal to, I want to make a vector of it. So I should do it this way. B is equal to capital bracket 1 space 2, capital bracket close, and when I hit enter, so this is your A variable. So A variable will not be affected. I have to go to B variable, right? B have been generated, B variable have been generated. So B, let's see what is in the B. So B, see, this is a row vector that has been generated with elements 1 and 2. Right. Okay, now let us make it as a column vector. So what you do is you just make a command of B is equal to semicolon 1 space 2 or 1 semicolon 2, and when you hit enter, so I tell that you have to break it off from here. You have to change the row from here. And when you hit enter, you'll see your B has been modified. Your B variable has been modified. And now it is a column vector of 1 and 2. Okay. So these are just the basics. You can do all sorts of operation. You can do multiply. You can do addition. So let's suppose I can do 3. Plus 5. Let's see what happens. So it throws me 8, and 8 will be saved in ANS variable. The new variable will be generated ANS if you do not define any thing to point into. So here answer will give you 8. Okay, this is how it is. It works. This is the philosophy of this particular mathematical tool. This is how it works. When I multiply A times So a, I want to multiply, or so, let's start with addition. So b plus answer. I want to add these two. So what is my b? So b, I have a column vector, which should be added with this 8. Okay. So what should you expect? Let me throw this, or let me save it in bb. Okay, bb. I mean, b plus answer should be saved in bb, and let me hit enter. So what happens? So bb has been generated and your addition has been done with the matrix b plus 8. So 8 plus 2, 10, and 8 plus 1, 9. So 9 and 10 should reflect 9 and 10 as a column vector, right? I want to now multiply bb times b. So when you do that, and I want to save in C. Sorry, I want to save it in C. C is equal to BB times B. Let's see what happens. So yes, I agree that. So your matrix multiplication follows certain rules. What are those rules? So your M. So if you are going to multiply M cross N matrix with M cross N or some non-multiplicable matrix, it will throw you an error. So the matrix dimension must agree. So that is why what I will do, I will transpose BB. Okay. So what I will do is I will transpose BB dash. Okay. And I will save it as an triple B. Triple B is equal to BB dash. Okay. It has thrown some row vectors. So now BBB times B. Okay, B is also my column vector. So now I can multiply these things. See, now it has been multiplied, right? You got the answer. Obviously, this would reflect as a scalar because 2 cross 1 and times 1 cross 2 you are doing. So you will get, 1 cross 2 times 2 cross 1. So you eventually will get 1 cross 1. So you get this one. So similarly, all sorts of things. So let me clear all variables. Clear all. So everything will be cleared. Okay. CLC. This the screen which you have done some messed up things. It can also be cleared. Yeah. Everything has been cleared. Okay. Now let me go from scratch. So let me define A is equal to. I want to define. So it's very cumbersome to define every elements each by each. So that is why you will take a help of inbuilt functions such as identity matrix. So EYE is the MATLAB function that makes identity matrix. So EYE, and you want to make how many? 3. So 3 cross 3, you want to make identity matrix of 3 cross 3. Okay, let's see what, let me hit enter, what happens. See, your A has been generated and it is essentially an identity matrix. So in one go, you have done a lot of things, right? I want to evaluate the eigenvalue of this matrix. So yes, you can also do that. So let's suppose value, you want to store this thing in value. Value is equal to EIG. EIG is the inbuilt function for getting out the eigenvalues of the matrix A. So let me hit enter. Let's see what happens. So yes, so eigenvalues are 1, 1, 1. If you do, yeah, this is a diagonal matrix and you can see it's obvious that 1, 1, 1 will be the eigenvalues of this identity matrix. Isn't it great? Okay, now, so all sorts of operation you can do. So now let's move towards writing the plotting the sine function, a typical sine function, sine ax plus omega t or something. Y is equal to sine x. Let's see. Let's plot that. Okay. So let me clear everything. Clear all CLC.
Sir.
Haan, bolo.
Sir, इसमें अगर हम कोई मैट्रिक्स प्लॉट करते हैं, जैसे सर अभी आपने आइडेंटिटी मैट्रिक्स किया ना सर,
हाँ,
वैसे कोई मतलब नॉर्मल मैट्रिक्स
प्लॉट
मतलब सर उसका सॉल्यूशन अगर आइगन वेक्टर या आइगन वैल्यू निकालते हैं सर उसमें, तो वो जो प्रोसेस है वो प्रोसेस भी बताता है ये कि डायरेक्ट आंसर आएगा आइगन वैल्यू,
डायरेक्ट आंसर देगा, ठीक है। प्रोसेस इसके पीछे क्या होता है, इसके पीछे आपको मैटलैब के साइट पे जाके आप पढ़ सकते हैं उसके बारे में, कैसे वर्क करता है, कैसे आइगन वैल्यू निकालता है, कैरेक्टरिस्टिक इक्वेशन बनाता है, अंदर ही अंदर वो एल्गोरिथम रन करता है, वो आपको बताएगा नहीं यहाँ पे, ठीक है। वो पढ़ना है तो आपको अंदर उसके ट्यूटोरियल जाके पढ़ना पड़ेगा, ठीक है। बट हम लोग ऑब्वियसली हम लोग इंजीनियर्स हैं, सो वी डोंट वांट टू गो इन टू द डिटेल्स बिकॉज वी नो दैट वी नो थिंग्स, वी नो हाउ द आइगन वैल्यूज आर कैलकुलेटेड एंड व्हाट इज द सिग्निफिकेंस ऑफ आइगन वैल्यूज। So eigenvalue is nothing but if you take if you have any matrix, you multiply with one vector, and if this vector is being elongated only or shortened in certain direction, so the elongation will give you, in physical sense, it will give you eigenvalue. Okay, the whatever scale that has been elongated by multiplying that matrix into that vector. So this is how it is. So ax is equal to lambda x, you do that, right? So you know, you guys, I mean, since you are in MTech, I believe that you guys know that what is the physical significance of this eigenvalues. So yes, so these MATLAB does do the operations inbuilt, but if you want to see those things, you have to go to the documentation part of it. Okay, so you can also go and check the documentation in this way, help eigen value, and let's hit enter. What happens? Let's see. So it will search the documentation. Okay, so let me click on that and it will open my documentation toolbar. Okay, and you can see eigenvalue problems and eigenvalue equation, eigenvalue problems. You can, or maybe help EIG. So let me write the proper function, EIG. So yes, it's there, doc EIG. So when I open EIG, so see how it is calculated. It is going to show the whole sort of documentation, how it works, how you can calculate your eigenvectors as well. Okay, it throws eigenvectors as well. Okay. So all sorts of things you can do here. So let us focus what we actually want to do here for the time being, because MATLAB is a whole way of ocean. You can dive into and you can go anywhere. You can do all sorts of things. So let us restrict our things just for plotting right now, and then we will move into the Blasius solution. Try to seek the Blasius solution from this ODE45 function, which MATLAB has inbuilt in it. Okay. Clear. CLC. So I want to plot y is equal to sine x. Okay. So sine x. So you should have some function. Okay, fine. Okay, you have x-axis, let's suppose you have x-axis and y-axis, and you want to say this is your, let's suppose this is your x and this is your y, which is nothing but the sine function that I want to plot sine over here. So this x should be, you should have some domain value, so range value, I mean, you should have some input value as x. So x is, you should have one, right? You should have grids, okay, on which you want to plot your function, 1 2 3 4 infinity, or some 2 pi, till 2 pi I want to go, and I want to plot those values on this graph, some whatsoever. Okay, so what I want to do is, first I want to discretize my x domain. Okay, so x I can write, I want to make a number of nodes I want to generate. So I want to make it, so it works on so you want to go till some ways, right? You can do this way. Okay, so this is not a advantageous way, because if you want to go to till 100, you have to write all 1s to 100. So there is a better way to actually do that. Okay, so better way is x is equal to, so there is an inbuilt function called linspace, linspace. So it does it linearly with equal divisions. It throws you from, I want to go from 0 to 2 pi to star pi. Pi is an inbuilt function in this MATLAB. So pi, it takes as a pi value. 0 to pi, I want to go. 0 to 2 pi, rather, I want to go with the spacing, or with the number of points inside it is 50. So in one shot, I will generate all those points. Okay. So when I hit enter, let's see what happens. See, so you have generated 1 cross 50 row vector, okay, till 2 pi. So 2 pi will be 3.14 times 2 is, it's almost close to 6.28. Okay, so it has generated 50 points from 0 to 2 pi. This is your 2 pi at 50th location. And yes, your domain has been created. Okay, now once you have generated the domain, now you want to one more thing. So you don't want to keep working on your command window, so that is why what we want to go is, now we are in a process to write a new script. So let us write new script, rather than every time you don't want to jumble across this command window. So this is my editor window. So this is a script window. You want to write your codes here. Let me clear things all. So and CLC. So nothing is there. Now this is your zero script file. I mean, this is your blank script file, and you start with a clear. So this is a good practice to write clear all CLC. Sorry, CLC and close all, so that clear all will clear all your variables, CLC will clear this screen, close all will close all the pictures or the graphs you have plotted. And let us save it in the same folder named advanced fluid mechanics. So AFM is my AFM underscore sine. I want to plot sine. So this is how it is renamed. Okay, so this has been created in the same folder, AFN underscore sign. Okay, so now first define my x. So x is equal to, I want to define my domain x. X is equal to linspace. Okay, linspace 0 to 2 star pi. Okay, I have written 0 to 2 pi. And I want to make things, number of points would be 50. And you have to suppress this line with semicolon. So if you don't want to, if you will not suppress this thing, let me show you what happens. So if I don't want to suppress it, and if I want to run this code, so if I want to run this code, so what happens? Let's see. So see, your command window will shows all values here unnecessarily. I don't want to see the output of right now. Okay, so I want to suppress my output, so that is why I will put my semicolon sign over here. Obviously x has been generated in workspace, obviously from 0 to 2 pi, but I don't want to see things in command window. So I want to hit run right now again. So let's see. So when I hit it, it doesn't mess out my command window, and it has cleanly executed with values given in here. Okay, so x variable is now 0 to your till 50 values you will get, till 50 you 50 points you have discretized till 2 pi. Okay, now I want to write my y is equal to, so inbuilt function in MATLAB is sine only. you just have to write y is equal to sine of x. That's it. It's so simple if you want to suppress. Okay, now let's run this and let's see what happens. So let's close this x. So right now only x variable is there, and now it will have x and y both variable will be here. And let's see when I hit run what happens. I hit run, your x is there, also y has been executed, and y also there is a row vector that has been generated from some function value to some function value. Okay, so I would expect from sine 0 should be 0 and sine 2 pi is should also be 0. So this is the minimum and maximum values that has been there. So this is minus 1 and plus 1. Obviously sine value cannot go plus 1 to minus 1. And MATLAB works on numerical techniques. That is why this is also 0. Sine 0 is equal to 0. And sine 2 pi is also 0, because you see the number is very huge here. So 2 into 10 to the power minus 16 is close to 0. Okay, so this you can see this is 0. And MATLAB does this way because it undergoes some numerical procedures, and that is why exact 0 you cannot find. So essentially this is 0. Okay, no worries. Okay, now I want to actually see the plot, right? So for plotting this sine x, you write it in this way. You have to write in this way. Okay, you have to write in this way. Figure, figure, figure. I want to plot it in figure 1, and you can write this function called plot. Plot. You have to give plot command. Plot. Okay, now plot x comma y. So my x is x variable is x and y variable is y. That's it. Okay, and let's see, and let's save this and let's run this command and let's see what happens. See, so beautiful, it has been generated, right? Isn't it? Okay, now more tweaks we can do. We also want to plot cos of x on top of it. So what I will do is I will define another variable called z is equal to cos of x this time, and I want to plot this cos of x on top of it. Okay, so what I will do is I will plot x comma y. I will tell this figure that hold on. Okay, hold on, I want to plot one more plot on it, and that is cos command, and that is z value. So x comma z I want to plot this time, and I want to plot this z cos with some other color, such as let's suppose blue. So inverted comma b with blue, and this I want to plot with red. And also I want things to be in star manner, and for B I want to plot it in O. Some O subscript will be there. Okay, now let's hit and let's see what happens. See, your red thing is your sine curve and your blue thing is your cos curve. Okay, now want to label x and y axis. So there are lots of commands that you can do. So x label, you want to x axis, y label, you want to write as sine and cosine functions. So it has been labeled x-axis and sine and cosine function. So all sorts of things you can do. So now let's quickly jump into the, since we have done the basics, now we can switch to this, to code this thing. I can understand that it would be hard for you to understand, but let's do this. Okay, So let's clear everything. Let's close this thing. Clear all. Close all. The plots will be closed. And let's start with new script. Okay. Okay, so in the new script, what I will do is our philosophy is, let us go and see what ODE45 does. Okay, so help ODE45, because I know that it's ODE45 or ordinary differential equation solve solution. Let's go to the documentation part of it. So this is how the MATLAB solves it. So idea of the syntax are given here. So it solves ODE45 solves non-stiff differential equations, medium order or methods. So syntax is t comma y. So your differential equations, the dependent variable is y and independent variable is time. So y and t, it is given in this fashion. So you have to write your syntax t comma y. You have to go to the solver. Solver is ODE45. You have to write ODE45 here. Let me show you here. Okay, this is your example. Are you guys able to see? This is your example. So it has three coupled equations. Okay. And which is what we have already written over here. Three coupled equations. No, we have not written it. Okay, let me do this quickly over here. Let me do this quickly over here. So you are able to see this. Okay, now what I will do is so this is your third order differential equation. The philosophy of ODE45 is you have to make all these differential equation into first order equations in some way or other. Okay, you have to write everything in first order. That is what the philosophy of ODE is. So it sees ODE sees some first order and it solves, it gives you solution. Okay, so to do that, what our philosophy would be, I will write my f is equal to f1. Okay. And I will write f df1 by d eta is equal to f2. The first differential of f is f2. Okay, this is my first equation. Now the second equation, df2 by d eta, again, I write it as f3. Okay. So f3 is what exactly? So f1, if you put f over here, this f2 is nothing but df by dt, so df by d eta, and this f, you put it over here, so f3 is nothing but d2f by dt square d eta square, isn't it? So now take this equation and write. So this is your first equation, this is your second equation, first order equation. Okay, this is your first order equation, first order, second first order equation, and third first order equation in d f3 by d theta. Okay, one more differentiation. This is nothing but d cube f by d eta cube, isn't it? Yawala. Okay, so essentially my thing is to convert this third order equation into three first order equations. This is how it is written. So one first order equation is this, second first order equation is this, third first order equation is this. This plus half of f, so this f is f1, this one here, times d2f by dt cube. So d2f by dt cube is nothing but f3. So simple. So now I have in my hand these three equations only. which is which are df1 by d eta is equal to f2, df2 by d eta is equal to f3, and df3 by d eta is equal to minus of 0.5 f1 times f3. Now I have to write this function in MATLAB. Okay. With boundary condition, this. So with boundary condition is this. So now let's switch to MATLAB. Okay. Now MATLAB. I first write a function, and I will call that function. And okay, let me open this first because this would be tricky. Where is the MATLAB help? Yes. So now I have converted my third order differential equation with these 1, 2, 3. Okay, first order differential equation with these boundary conditions. Right. Well, f0 is 0, f2 0 is 0, f3 0 is equal to some guess. That is what we told. F0 is 0, f2 0 is 0, f3 0 is equal to some guess. That is what our idea would be. Okay. And to do that, you have to write a function in this way, in certain way. I'm going to write this right away. So my function would read as function is equal to df beta not equal to this function df beta I will define as my function. I'll call this some name, my function. Now I have defined my function, and let me save this with the same name as my function. And this is how the MATLAB works. You have to make sure that this file name should match with this function name. Okay, this is how MATLAB works. You don't have to worry about much right now. So let me write these differential equations in this way. So df d eta is equal to, this is how you have to define your MATLAB function. So f2, so this is f2, f3, and this thing I will define. Okay, and these three differentiation equations will be defined accordingly. So f2, f3, and this right hand side thing I have to write. So f2 semicolon f3 semicolon minus 0.5 times, what is that, f1 times f3, times three, semicolon, and I will end that and I will save that. Okay, there is a mismatch of parenthesis, capital bracket should be here. Okay, now I'll save this. So my function has been saved, and let me close this. Okay, my function has been, I will call this function, and I will try, I'll tell that now solve this. Okay, so clear all CLC, close all, right? And let me save this as Blasius, AFM Blasius, AFM underscore Blasius, some name. Okay, now I will directly go and see what is my documentation say. You just have to call ty ode45 and this function. You have to call in this fashion. So ode45, your function calling, and this is your time span. So your t or eta should go from 0 to some value, and this particular guy who's sitting over here is your initial conditions, 0, 0, some guess I will write it over here. That's it. So this is so easy, isn't it? Eta, comma, F, I'll write ODE 45, bracket, at the rate, I have to call that function, which we have saved. So this is move function. Okay, this is your move function. I missed that. I mean, misspelled as my as move. So let me write it move only. Move function. Move, mu fun. Okay, comma. I want to go from eta from 0 to, let's suppose 10, I want to go 5. Let's suppose I want to go to 5. Okay. And that is my t span or my eta span. And then I've already defined my initial condition. So F1 is 0. Initial condition is 0. Second initial condition is also 0. And third initial condition is some guess. So I'll throw some number. I'll throw some number 1 or 0.1. I don't know. So I will have some philosophy. Or maybe I'll write it guess. Because I don't know this. Okay. And I have to define my guess also. Guess is equal to. Initially, I will define something just for practice purpose. Then we'll remodify our code. Let's first define guess as 0.1. Okay. And that bracket close. And then I want to plot my eta functions. Okay. So I will want to plot. So F will be saved as. Eta, comma, F. It's over. So now let me run this and let's see what happens. Let's run this. See, you got some values. So let me do one thing. Let's plot F, comma, eta. I have rotated my axis. And I will limit my. Let's see what happens. Well, very nice. Okay, so let me go it till 10. Let's see what happens. Okay, so now your green plot is basically the Blasius solutions. So essentially this, you have F have been generated. Let's see what F has been generated over here. So F value is, so first column is your F1, second column is your F prime, third column is your F double prime. And this is what your solution reads. And you see that your second solution is your Blasius solution. Basically, I told that in the Kund Cohen, I already told that F dash is your proper solution, right? F dash was, I mean, your velocity profile is linked to F dash, not other variables, right? F dash is your velocity profile. So F dash is nothing but this second column is your F dash, and it reaches till 0.44. Now I want to reach things to till 1. Okay, so I want to increase this. I want to increase as, let's suppose I increase till 1. Now let's see what happens. Okay, so the green thing is your velocity profile. It's coming, but again, let's match things, or it crosses 1. Okay, so this is what your guess work. You have to come up with an optimal guess. So I have done already my coding did some calculations, and I did that. Your guess value should be equal to 0.3323. When I take that, this initial guess value, and I run this code, and yes, now your solution actually converges. Let's see what happens to F2. Actually, it goes till 1, isn't it? It goes till 1, and that's my solution. So this red one is your F1, that is your first variable. F2 is actually your velocity profile. That would look something like this. And this is the way you should solve it. Okay, this was, I agree that this was a bit difficult for you guys, but I mean, start practicing it properly and you will have command over MATLAB. Okay, and obviously this guess value, I have come up with certain manipulation, which I may not talk right now, because you have to put something like this. Okay, let me quickly close it over here, and let me open things in here. And let me share quickly. I'll take just 2 minutes. Okay. What happens? You are actually marching your solution. So you are starting. You will have some from zero. You are going to march, and at one, you want to reach. Okay. So. So at one, so this is your eta and this is your f dash, right? This was your thing. So you start with some guess. When you start with some point one, you see that your profile looks something like this. Okay, so you are lagging behind with some p1 value. When your guess was one, okay, so when your guess was one, you overestimated it. Okay, so you have to. So you find P2. So you have to interpolate things, and you have to make your code accordingly so that you can reach till you reach satisfy this one condition. Unless you reach this one, you will not stop it. So this is how the philosophy would be to find your solution. So I don't want to comment more, but yes, I also agree that it will be difficult to understand currently, but start doing numerical things in MATLAB and you will eventually achieve slowly in time. Okay, so yes, so that's it from my side. So any other questions if you want to ask?
No, sir.
Okay. So hope this MATLAB session will give you some insight, right? I cannot